Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. And in this video I want to show you the use of the chain harrow to remove the molehills. Now it's winter time, we're going towards spring. It's already a very nice sunny day already. But there's a lot of molehills in the field and I want to flatten them out. What I will use is a very old chain harrow. So this chain harrow I bought many years ago from a farmer, which already then was very old, so this is it's almost antique. And I always used a chain to connect it towards the Kubota B600DT. And now when I use it with the B226-1, then I saw that the chain has a tendency to come to the backside of the bore to hit it. So that's what I don't want. So I will now change the chain and I will replace it with a top link. See if that improves. At the backside you also see a Walsh. That Walsh is there to flatten it even further out. The chain harrow is already flattening the molehills, and with the walls it even flats out even more. So it's just a simple construction that I once tried, and it works quite nice to flatten out the molehills. What I will do is I will take out the chain, replace it with the top link, see if that improves the handling, and if that prevents indeed that the backside is getting damaged. We'll see. So here you see the chain harrow. So the first bar is really to take out the first part of the hill. The second part does it again. Now here you see the chains a little bit more closer, and you can see that at the bottom side there's a longer pin. At the top side it is smaller. It's already used a lot, so it's already worn out a little bit. But what you can see is that at this side the pin is longer than on the other side. So you can change. You can choose whether you want to have the long side down or the small side down. This way it will go on deeper. Now I always take it the pin down, because then also the moss is removed a little bit, and that's what I like about it. And also it will shuffle it a little bit more. So if you want, you can take the whole chain out and turn it around, and then you will have the shallow or the deep notches, whatever you prefer. So the final bar is smoothing it out even further. So what I did on top of the chain harrow is I added the walls at the end. This is not originally there, it was lying around, and I filled it up with sand, so it's a very heavy thing. And I added it that the end part is even flattened out even further. So then it really helps to keep the whole field smooth. Sometimes you see the mole already pushing up the hills again when I just pass it again, which is always nice to see me working the other way and he working this way. In the old days I used mole traps and things like that to take them out, but I don't do that anymore. They're useful animals, they take the larvae of several insects. When there's a mole, that also means that the ground is really healthy, so and I don't care. So I just flatten out, and then after a while do it again, and we're friends now. So I showed you the usage of the chain harrow as I use it here in the field in the Low Countries. It's a beautiful day today. It's very warm for the time of year. It's still winter, but let's enjoy it. I really like to smoothen the whole field, make it flat again, so there's no bumpy anywhere when I will continue on mowing and other stuff. So that's something that I need to do, and you need to repeat that because the mole is also still active. Next to that, of course, also good to aerate the grass and also to take out the moss a little bit. Now, to improve on the aeration as well as the moss removal, next step is to go into verticutting, and that's something I will show you in another video. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.